But first, a dramatic say goodbye from four of S Club. Joe, John, Hannah and Bradley were on the Liquid sofa just minutes ago to give their farewell interview, but the foursome send-off ran into some difficulty. First, here's the band's brilliant goodbye single.
Road ahead holds different dreams for me.
There are going to be lots of people weeping as they play that. Joe, first of all, I don't understand. Why are you splitting up?
I think the reason that we've decided to do it now is because we've achieved everything that we can as a band, and we've done a movie and we've been really successful. So it's nice to go out on a high and while people actually still like us.
But Bradley, don't you think you could do a bit more? You could do another year?
Yeah, well, I suppose if we really wanted to, we could push it. But I think, you know, we don't want to. We just want to adventure out and do our own things, and the main thing is we'll always be friends,
and
we'll always keep in contact with each other and just work
and egg each other on. Hannah, how weird was it denying it all? Because so many times people ask whether you were splitting up. You must have known. You were going, no, we love each other. Thinking in your head, oh, give it a couple of weeks.
Mm. Well, it was just until we all decided together that we really wanted to do it. Obviously, there's that time when you're thinking to yourself, and then you come. I mean, we were thinking about it about 2 months beforehand, but until we were certain, we weren't going to come out and say it. So,
John, who wanted to split up the most?
Paul, probably. That's where he left.
Yes.
But then after that, I don't know. It was kind of a joint decision. We just kind of all come to the thing together. We spoke about it quite a lot over those 2 months and stuff, and it just comes to the point of, you know, we just didn't want to do it anymore, but not in a bad way.
Let's talk cash. Mr. Simon Fuller, okay, please don't look at me like you're angry. He's got 90 million in the bank.
How much?
90 million.
90 now?
Yes.
That's 50 last week.
No, I thought it was 130.
No, it is 90. There are rumours, I don't know how true they are, that you guys are grumpy because you haven't made a mint.
No, that's not true.
Are you not grumpy about it?
We didn't get a mint. I would love a mint. My breath, I didn't.
Yeah, I'm a bit pungy, actually.
No, just.
Did you get?
I think we're all really, really lucky to be where we are today at our age and have the bank balances that we do have.
To help sift through the showbiz news of the day is our top reporter, Vanessa Langford.
Wow.
Why do you think that happened?
I think the words are on that bombshell. I think it's just a brilliant insight into the way the whole PR machine works. It's fine if you're asking very sort of innocuous, benign questions, tell us about your new single. Your question wasn't that off the wall, and you could see kind of the band, the guys looked a little bit baffled, a bit puzzled, and then the PR came storming in.
Because it has been in the papers and they didn't give a list. You know, interview all sorts of people, everyone, and you're told, actually, you know what, don't ask this, but they seemed fine.
Absolutely. Usually, if PRs have touchy subjects, it's like, OK, this is off limits. If they didn't give you that, if they didn't give you the that kind of boundary limits, then you could have asked anything.
It is a brilliant single, and my introduction before this all happened was going to be just how much we're going to miss them. How much will you miss, personally, S Club?
Well, they were great, weren't they? They were really like plastic pop, and they kind of like replaced Steps, they replaced the Spice Girls, and they had, what was it, something like 10 top five singles in sort of 4 years, and they were just real great, fun, bubblegum pop. But we have got the S Club Juniors, so all will be saved.
All eight of them.